All right, children. So now let us try to understand about fluid pressure. But before we talk about fluid pressure, we must understand what is a fluid actually. So anything that flows is known as a fluid. Okay. Now just see a simple demonstration I am showing you here. This is a container, and in this container we have kept a particular liquid. Okay. Now, in this container I have made three holes over here, and what we can see is that from all the three holes the liquid is coming out in different speeds. Okay, so from the first it is not that much fast, the pressure is not that much high. In the second one the pressure is a little bit higher, and in the third one the pressure is much more higher. So what we can understand from here is that pressure is dependent upon height of the liquid column. On what? On the height of the liquid column. More the height, more the pressure. Okay. So let's understand that the formula for pressure becomes P is equal to H rho G. Okay, what is H? H is the height of the liquid column. What is rho? Rho is the density of the liquid, and G is the gravitational pull or acceleration due to gravity on earth. Okay, now I'll explain that how this formula came. Okay, so you can see in that side I have made a diagram. In this diagram there is a container, and in this container I have kept a cylindrical part I have assumed, named P, Q, R and S. Okay, so in this cylindrical part we will see that how the formula of pressure comes. So first of all, pressure on PQ. Now I think you all can see PQ, this part is the PQ. So we will try to understand how much pressure is applied on the surface PQ by the water. So that is equal to weight of liquid column PQRS. Okay. So whatever is the weight of the column of this liquid, that much pressure will be applied on this from the top. Right? Okay. Then weight means we can say what? Mass into gravity. Alright, so mass into gravity we have written over here. So instead of mass, can we write it volume into density? Because we know that, what do we know? We know density is equal to mass by volume. So therefore mass is equal to density into volume. Alright. So we have written in place of mass, volume into density. Into this G we will keep it as it is. Okay. Now can we write in place of this volume, can I write in place of this, can I write area into height? Same thing. Because volume means length into breadth into height. So length into breadth is area. So length into breadth into height into density, I am writing rho for it, and into G. Okay. So if we assume that the area of this surface is suppose A, so we can write over here A rho G H. Okay. Alright. Now, we must understand about area. Okay. Now we know that pressure is equal to force per unit area. So what is this force? This is the weight of this liquid only. So we can directly write down this one. That is A rho G H divided by the area. Okay, means area of the base. So therefore this and this gets cancelled. So what we are left with? Rho G and H. So pressure is equal to rho G and H. Okay. Now I think you understood till here. Now let's try to understand the factors on which the pressure depends. So pressure depends on, first of all, height of liquid column, secondly density of liquid, and thirdly acceleration due to gravity. So that means H, rho and G, these are the three things on which height of the liquid column depends. Okay, so laws of fluid pressure and consequences we will see later on. Okay, thank you.